The weather had been fantastic for quite a few days, and you really have to take advantage of this sort of thing when it occurs in Scotland, because before long the rain and the cloud and the wind usually returns. So after work, me and my son and the dog went for a wee walk, and we were heading to a hill called Murray's Hall Hill, which is often known as the Pinnacle Hill, which overlooks Perth. And although I've been looking at this hill for years and years and years, I'm ashamed to say I've only been up it once before. And we headed up through some lovely woodland with the sun speckling through the trees. It really was a fantastic evening, and made our way up towards the top of the hill. It's been a beautiful evening. It's been a beautiful day actually, but more so the evening. I was kind of hoping this cloud, you might be able to see behind me up there, I hope it was going to stick around a wee bit for sunset, but I don't think it will. You can see where the clouds come from over in the west. It's all clear and it's beautiful. And I've just come up a local hill for a sunset hike, me and the wee man and the dog, and we're hoping to get to the top of this hill, which in over 40 years living in the area, I'm ashamed to say I've only been up it once before. Anyway, a bit more about that in a little while, but it's an absolutely stunning evening. It's hard to believe that a little over a week ago I was trudging through the snow. That's the great thing about spring in Scotland. Anyway, let's get to the top. Let's go. We were soon making our way out of the forest and up over some lovely moorland and fields. And at one point I had to put the dog in the backpack because the long grass and the thorns and the nettles were stinging our feet. And we headed up, the views were great, and you could see so many Munros and mountains of Scotland from here, from afar. The views really were wide-reaching. Just come behind this bush to get out of the wind a wee bit, but we're nearly at the top of the pinnacle, which is just over my shoulder there, and it kind of looks over Perth. And I've looked at it for years and years. My house where I grew up when I was a kid looked across Perth from the other side, and I could always see this hill, and it's a... I don't know, it's bad that I've not been up here all this time. This will be my second time. It looks like we'll have the wee summit to ourselves. You see, it's over there. So we better get a crack-a-lack on, because the sun's going to go down, I don't know, in the next half an hour. We've still got a few fields to negotiate. Don't we, Lewis? Right, to the top.
After
making our way through that yellow, spiky gorse, which was quite sore at times, we were soon approaching the top of the Pinnacle or Murray's Hall Hill, where there's an obelisk. And this was built by the members of the Graham Murray family, who owned Murray's Hall. Well, it's Murray's Hall Hotel now, but it's an old house which they occupied for about 260 years. And it's a big, big obelisk, a big monument, which probably gives the name of the hill the Pinnacle as we know it, although it's probably called Murray's Hall Hill. Anyway, we sat down here after our exploits and had a wee drink and a wee treat, some sweeties to boost our energy levels. And that sun was starting to lower. But the views were fantastic, and we could pick up so many of the Munros that we've been up in the past from here. Lovely.
I've tried to hide around the back of this monument, the Pinnacle. That's where the name of the hill comes from. And I just read the plaque, and it was dedicated to a chap called Thomas Graham in the 19th century. And I'll probably do more in the voiceover in a wee while on the way down about this monument, because we need to get cracked on now. The sun's away to dip below the horizon, and we've got a fair bit to get back down the road. So let's get going.
Built in 1850, the obelisk monument was a memorial to Thomas Graham, who was a war hero. And it's quite a sad story. He didn't join the military until the death of his wife in his early 40s. And I think this was really to just try and get over the sad events that had happened. And he became a war hero and went over and fought in the British battles over in Spain and Portugal, where the Allied forces were helping them free the land from the invading French. And he survived these wars and eventually returned home and lived to the grand age of 93. And after his death, they built this monument on top of Murray's Hall Hill. And what a place to have it. The views over to the Highlands and right across Perthshire are absolutely superb. Not to mention the views to all those famous Munros like Sehalian and Ben Vorlich and Ben Moore and what have you. And these views were just as good as we reached Macduff's Monument, a small folly where we sat and watch the sun go down before taking some photographs. Lovely.
the jacket on. We're in Macduff's Monument here, wee folly. And the sun's just about down now. I think if I come out here, you'll see it's just about to go down. I think it's Farragon Hill that's going down over there. Not far from Schehallion. It's lovely though. But it's getting a bit parky now, so get the jacket on. Dog's in the lead. Just got to negotiate a few fields. And it's back home. Right, shall we make a move? Let's go. Right. So with the sun just dipping below the horizon over the Scottish Highlands, we left Macduff's Monument and started to head back down towards the car and back through those forests. And it was getting dark, but we didn't quite need the head torches. We managed to get back to the car before it got dark. But what a great wee adventure. And it just shows you don't have to travel too far to have fun and get out into the great outdoors. What a fabulous evening.